Hey, what's up, dudes? Kublai Khan here. Welcome back to Fallout 4 Automatron DLC. Yes, so remember how last episode I mentioned, do you guys think these intros are cool? These ones where we fly around looking at these grandiose views of the wasteland, seeing the destruction that has occurred, and then we get this little bit of exposition to understanding what's happening with our character, where they're located, and what next steps there are on our missions? Well, I wanted to remind you guys because I made a mention of it and I realized I could just put a vote up too. So go ahead and click above me for her to see a little vote. See if I remember to do it for the next video. Well, there was also that main point, which is that I wanted to ensure that I didn't do something that, you know, made a lot of you guys who have been watching this consistently unhappy about. So I'm like, hey, just let me know down below with your opinion on it. Let me know either above as well. I think both of them are good. It's I was just looking at the audience retention graphs and I saw that a bunch of perfect. Shut up. I saw that there was a bunch of skips that was happening on the audience retention. It's not stopping.
Union violation detected. Last recorded break was 9,000.
Union violation of the robot? The robot have a union violation? Interesting. All right, I want you to blow the crap out of this guy. Oh, not to inspect it. He's just, you know what? Fine, we'll just leave him. This is a good place for the robot to live, so he will live here. Okay, for whatever reason, I couldn't actually get my HUD indicator to show up. So I didn't really know where I was going. And now that we have that up, I can figure out where I am going. Things are good. Oh man, this harvester. So this is the same path that our S. Brian, our very first permadeath. Sorry, we had a little glitch there. Our very first permadeath player actually managed to take. Oh, memories. Which means that we're about to come up on a raider camp in front of us, which is where S. Brian had to run from because she was getting hurt and killed. And also, what's nice about this place is that they have a fusion core right there. So we can go ahead and grab that too while we're on our way. And then off in this direction, we have the guy who sells chems and things. Don't worry about it, Ada. I'm actually just gonna grab this fusion core and go. We have other things that are more important to deal with. I know, they're shooting at me and I just don't care. It doesn't matter. I just stole a fusion core and ran. I'm surprised I don't see more Fallout 4 crimes like this. Or it's just a character is... Oh, Rust Devil. Alright, bruh. Whoa! That's a big scary robot in the background, too. Alright, well, first we're gonna go Rust Devil to Rust Devil. Alright, we'll go to this one first. That is an awesome helmet! You're getting shot by your own robot, dude. You're next. Followed by you. Oh, God. And then we're going to go to the robot next, if we can. Hack it. Perfect. Shut it down. God, can you imagine how frightening this fight would be? This dude, you'd think this dude in a suit would have to fight these big scary things one-on-one, but instead, oh no, he just shuts down the robot. Another Rust Devil. All right. Oh! That was cool.
I suggest we take as much as we can carry.
Man, I already have a chest piece. That's what I'm wearing right now. Left arm and right leg. Oh, I get it. So they wear the protection of the robot armor.
Engaged.
Who are you going after? Is it like a dog from the, No? Okay, well, bye. Oh, man. This is wicked. Now we can also deal with this robot here. All right, big guy. Hold on. There we go. Sneak attack. Oh, it's not dead yet. Well, hold on. General Chow is the one to go then. Oh, God! You think I need to learn by now that that's the... Two fusion cores? Jesus Christ, this guy was loaded. That's, we're okay. We still have armor on our general bodies and whatnot. This sword is definitely the way to go with sneak attacks now because it gets four times. Can be destroyed. Or placed in the pit boy. Well, unfortunately, I don't really have any of those options. Now, what happened to the rest of the body? I wanted to wear that one helmet where it was the EDE head thing or the little flying robot dude. All right, you don't have it. Well, it appears to have been blown away to Kingdom Come, wherever that went. So, I mean, we did just set off a mini nuke. Still, I'm a little disappointed about that. I was all excited about having our opportunity to wear this silly helmet. Also, that showed me a good example of how powerful, you know, we actually lost only half our health because I blew up the robot up in its face. So it's something to keep in mind that I actually don't necessarily need to blow the robot up next to its face, or I think I could put this power armor down and try the sneaking around a little bit, because it is making things relatively easier. You're just gonna die in a single swat. Oh my god. Uh-oh, I hear
him.
Oh, it was that robot. That slow motion citizens may now resume was pretty frightening. And so now I'm realizing that was just from that robot. So I still have a level up. I'm thinking about it, and I might actually want to do something like Scrapper. Aluminum and copper when scrapping weapons and armor. Because I don't know if those are the rare things you get, or if those are like the rare things you get, because I would love adhesives from tearing down some pipe pistols and stuff like that. That would be super beneficial for us. Anyway, I have plenty of hub flowers, so I think I might actually do that, because I haven't found yet an ability that really makes this perk useful. We could also just jump up strength, though, which in general is just going to be nice. Just more kills. But human beings haven't really been a problem. Sneaking, on the other hand, has been problematic, and it might be really nice to be able to take our character out of this and sneak up to be able to do most of the killing. We are pretty close anyway to the Fort Hagen, so we can get excited. All right, I'm gonna try sneaking this. So let's hop out. Very good. Save. Sneak time. Pull out the blade. I already hear someone saying, intruder, identify yourself.
Further escape attempts. Lawbreaker.
Well, crap. Oh, and the legendary mutant has already evolved. Was this it? This was it. This was reduced damage for animals by 50%. Oh, that's really cool. Well, that was the legendary creature.
Are you injured, sir?
No, I haven't even been shot. Ow! Ow! God damn! Whoa! Oh, slow-mo. That's right, we have the slow-mo ability. Well, the Protectron got killed by that. God damn it. Oh. Will you? Will you, Ada? God damn it. Ay, 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 ay. Get it, get it. Got it. Okay. So, Oh, ow, ow, ow! Where's the shooting come from? Alright, she's dealing with it. Jesus Christ! Every moment we get out of our suit of armor, we are in danger. Then we're good. Then we get back into the suit of armor, and things are just like, hey, you're fine, you're fine. And then suddenly, jeez. It's cray-cray. What is this? Is this a robot? Okay, I don't know. Let's go get this Rust Devil. We haven't really been able to sneak at all, though. Oh, that was cool. That running stab? I like that. There we go. Take some of your stuff. Yeah, it's just sneaking doesn't seem to work because we keep starting to sneak and our robot immediately sets off the entire angry process. Though we are about to go into a building. And when you go into the building, you definitely have a little bit extra protection from, you know, like that immediate charge in. You know, I've never been to this satellite array. In fact, every time I've ever tried to go into it, it's been filled with Yao Guy. So, what is... That is cool. Can I have a robot like that? Entry terminal. Lookout duty? With all these mechanics bots on the loose, we can't afford to skip on lookouts. For all we know, the bastard is planning a raid to take all our... Oh, they're... All these mechanists. Oh, no lockjaw. This doesn't mean you can set three bots to patrol the area and take a nap. I want at least two living, breathing humans patrolling. And let me know immediately if you see some strange bot come over the hill. Security door? Yeah, open that. I don't know where that opened. I'm like a bunch of Yao Guy come charging out. I'm like, God damn it! That would have been pretty rough. All right, we'll make the jump here. We'll make the jump here. Let's go ahead and grab the armor and bring it inside with us. I think that will be... Oh, I just opened that door. Good. Let's bring it inside with us. I don't think I'm going to be immediately assaulted by a bunch of opponents, and I still want to try sneaking through. So I want to have the armor available to me. I would feel that these guys would have tons of power. I'm surprised they don't. Anyway, I would feel that I would have the... I have nine. We got two from that one robot that I was able to shut down. The idea that we were able to just... I still want to try sneaking, yada, yada, yada. Oh, down. And so I'm going to leave this robe, or our suit right here while I do this. Perfect. Ada, you can come along with me. Let's pull out the sword. All right, so snuck in. We have a laser tripwire, fiber optics, and crystal. Ada, I'm glad that you can fly. And actually, I think it might be useful to have you stuck up there right now. Salt. Oh, that's terrifying. An Assaultron totem? Sheesh. Okay, continuing through. Hello? Ooh, ashtray. Hello? Mr. Handy Wrecker and a Dust Devil. Okay. Let's see how successful we can do this. Oh, he's coming to us. Now, should I just blitz this dude? Yeah, let's try it. All right, now do they see me? Are we good? Oh, that's the first time we've gotten stealth to really work. Hell yeah. Oh, finally, I'm a ninja. Oh, he doesn't know where I actually am. He just thinks he knows. Here, let me pull out the human pulverizer. Ada, are you still gone? Yeah, she is. You know, I was watching many a true nerd play his particular Automatron playthrough, and he gave his robots a head that made it so that they don't engage unless you're really close. Wow, that guy was very surprised. Just all of a sudden, he's like, oh no! Got a freaking fusion core? Alright, I hear someone saying fugitives on the loose. But anyway, many a true nerd had a robot that has a very close viewpoint. What's the word I'm looking for? He only can engage targets very nearby. This ensures that he's able to sneak around pretty well. That was something that I did not think about when I designed Ada. I was like, yeah, she should be able to shoot people from far away, but jeez. Alright, that was a human. Switch to the human weapon.
Description to designated law enforcement authorities.
This is working okay so far. What do you think? Hey. Ooh, legendary Rust Devil. Oh, nice. This should do it. Nice. God, I love Blitz with sneaking. Does increase the amount of damage as the night grows longer and lesser. It's okay. It's a melee weapon. That's new. Ada?
Yo.
Stay.
Hold.
Stay.
Why not let the robot deal with it?
Okay. This is nice. This is a new way to play that I'm excited that we get to experiment with. You know what might be fun too, instead of killing some of these robots, is actually just shutting them down. But because we have so much damage and it's just night, it's faster to kill them, I'm okay with it so far. And also, we can kill them from afar as we jump forward.
Man, please don't be fair.
Oh god! Who's shooting me? Oh shoot, up there. Ada! Ada!
Yes.
Follow!
I'll get it done.
Oh god, it's a human! It's a robot! What is it? It's a Mr. Handy Wrecker! Just hit it a bunch! Don't explode! Don't explode! Don't explode! Don't explode! Don't explode! Don't explode. Don't explode. Yay! Alright, first person, so that we can see how we're moving through the world. Light on, so I can see what's going on. Mr. Handy Wrecker. Whap. Whap. Yes, General Chow is having revenge. Oh man, this is a lot. Protectron Devil. This is a lot more satisfying to cut through these guys with weapons than it is to just hack them. Up. Oh, super Sledge. Oh, I don't have any of this anymore. This is for you. Oh, knocked him through the air. That's for you. still in danger. Hold on, what are we taking from this guy? All right, that works. Human or robot? Ooh, a place where we can repair our military grade duct tape. I can't wait to add the heating coil damage addition to this. Rust Devil.
Engaging hostile target.
Ooh, they got power armor too. Ooh, this is fun. Oh, you got it. Hey,
heads up.
Ada, go ahead and unlock the security gate. So, we didn't really need the extra sneak.
This lock appears to be a bit tricky, but I'll do my best.
Well, you rock it.
Here we are, unlocked as requested.
Jesus Christ, Ada. You're gonna, you know, give me a little suspense. Warmonger spiked plate. Interesting. Give me a little suspense, Ada. You know, like, oh, I don't know if I could do it. Beep, beep, beep. Beep, boop, boop. Beep, boop, boop. Beep, boop. Okay, I got it. And it's like, yeah, there we go. A lot of robot repair kits. Oh, is this a fusion? No, this is not a fusion core thing. This has worked out great. We've been able to get in, slice away our opponents just fine. No terrible danger, no terrible pain.
Find anything useful?
Yeah, I'm looking for it. Here, I'm gonna do a little looting. Oh yeah, a little bit of a PSA, I guess. For Automatron, a lot of things require ceramic. So plates, cups, a lot of that kind of stuff. Make sure you're on the lookout for it when you're playing. Also, I just realized that this is a tank, a double-barreled tank. That just seems ridiculous to me, but I realize that there have been some double-barreled, like, naval ships as well, so I can get that, kinda. Ooh, this power armor has a fusion core? Hold on. You know, my power armor is actually missing some stuff, so let's actually go ahead and grab this for when we can take it around and see if it actually has better armor, like it's just equipped better than my last armor suit. Plus, if we're about to get in some radioactive material.
No way I could pick this.
Yo, Ada, this one's for you too. Ada, Ada.
Hey.
Ada, where are you going? Ada, Ada, come back. Oh, I can unlock this one. Ah, Ada, look what I can do. You know, it's weird having a companion that doesn't say like, ooh, crap. That doesn't give you, oh my God, I just. So, one of the advantages of having these robots, besides making your perfect companion, is you don't have to worry about them disliking traveling with you. So if you really like Kate, it's like a lockpicking ability, but you don't like how she wants you to be mean. There is an advantage to the fact that you have a. Good luck, Ada. There is an advantage that.
Let me try something else.
Oh, I hope she's able to do this. I am in suspense.
Nope, that's not it. Well, ooh. That's that. I'm sorry, this lock was trickier than I assumed.
You unlocked the previous expert one. I wonder if, So remember we had a position where she tried to unlock something, but she wasn't able to do it before. There's a computer over on this one and a lot of radio. Wait a second. Oh, this is the door we were just in. Okay. Nice. Ooh, right away. Right away, Med-X and a typewriter. Ooh, Vault-Tec lunchbox. Oh, it was teaching the teddy bear stuff. That's cute. Aw, and teddy bears are great for leather. Hells yeah, grabbing that. Okay, we actually, in the beginning of the game, I needed a lot of leather and I didn't have any access to it. And it was super disappointing. Lockdown. Interesting. Security door control. Oh, we've already opened this. I don't remember when. I'm guessing they must have. Oh my God, there's a lot of robots here. All right, we're not in any danger at the moment, so I'm just going to turn off my light, continue on with my discussion that I said that I wanted to be traveling without this power armor. Ada, I would actually like you.
Hey.
I'd be happy to help if I can.
Here.
Certainly.
Go there. Just stick there for a second. Oh, and look, Jingles the Moon Monkey is now in a wheelchair. Feel better, Jingles. Okay. Ooh, this is a pretty place. You know, I really wish I visited the Fort Hagen satellite before it was the mechanist environment. Ugh. Ooh, what's... Oh my God, we might be able to do upgrade all the weapons into what we want them to be. I hear the mechanist again. Oh, it's the Robobrain. Ahab. This is interesting. What's going on in this place? Speak to Jezebel? So robo-brains are human brains that are attached to robots? What the hell is this? Ahab. He looks frightening. And I'm guessing you're Jezebel? Interesting. And then we have an EDE stuck in a rust of a workshop terminal. And we'll take these, why not? What is going on? This is interesting. Choose an entry. Ooh. The brain won't talk. Make it. Smash the glass and stick your hand in it if you have to. The brains are obviously the ones calling the shots. There has to be some signal hidden inside the slimy ball of snot. Wait until tomorrow. That's when someone else to do it. Just do it. iBot. I'm sick of hearing these incessant messages. Bring peace. Blah, blah, blah. Schematics. I don't necessarily want to kill it yet, so let's just shut it down for the moment.
I come to warn you of a new scourge who stalks the innocent.
That's not working. Jeez, look at the way that they treat these robots, like if they're human beings just cut and locked up around here. Alright, I'm guessing that there's gonna be a boss fight right now, so let's go ahead and get that going.
You don't look like one of the Rust Devils. What are you doing here?
Oh, this is wicked. Before we go talking about that, let me kill one of your friends, okay?
And destroys my robot allies. Only seeks to save lives.
Damn, it's not working. Hold on. No, no, I just wanted you to
take a look.
No, no, I just wanted you to open the door. Just open the door. Just shut it up. Just shut it up. God damn it. Okay. You know what? We're just gonna drown him out using that meditation stuff. What happened to you?
What did the Rust Devils do to you?
They felt that by keeping my head on mine would prove useful to them. Fortunately for me, they're stupid enough to actually believe anything I say. Admittedly, it hasn't gotten me very far, but it has saved me from the same fate as my rather unfortunate comrades you see in pieces around you.
That makes sense.
Back to my original question. What are you doing here?
I want to be sarcastic.
Maybe I'm just a Rust Devil wearing a clever disguise.
Please, don't insult my intelligence. Why don't you just tell me why you're here, and why we're even bothering to have this conversation?
Well,
hunting down a radar beacon.
A radar beacon? How very interesting.
That's right.
That's a very specific part to be searching for, and you don't look like the typical part scavenger type to me.
Ada is here
with
me.
I calculate a 98.8% chance that you're looking for the mechanist.
Right on,
babe. If I'm correct, and I usually am, then perhaps we can help each other with our respective predicaments.
Hey, I'd be happy to be involved.
I'm listening.
How refreshing. Then allow me to explain. Now, how can I put this as simple as possible so someone at your processing speed can understand?
Thank you, I appreciate it.
In order to find the mechanist, you're going to need more than just my radar beacon. You're going to need access to the facility.
Okay.
I'm willing to provide said access, but you'll have to fulfill two simple conditions. One, you need to get me as far away as you can from these lunatics.
Alright.
And two, find me a new body. Once both conditions are satisfied, I'll gladly provide you with everything you need.
That sounds fair.
Do we have a deal?
Ooh, I'm gonna ask that.
How do I know you'll keep up your end of the bargain?
Even though there's a human brain floating in a biogel inside my head, I'm still bound by my original programming. It pains me to admit it, but one of my directives states that I cannot lie. Ever.
Unless that is a lie.
While I'm not the most charming robot you've ever encountered, the last thing I'm going to do is violate an agreement we made.
Now
that we have
that
out of the way,
yeah, let's do it.
A wise decision. Once we're at our destination, I'll happily relinquish my radar beacon as a gesture of good faith.
I may not.
Now, I strongly suggest you stop loitering in the middle of a hostile location and get us both out of here at once.
Cool. So, Taker, I'm guessing that this guy is going to go start attacking us right when that happens. Please unlock the door so I can kill the stupid talking thing. You know what? Ada, just move over here. We're gonna use a grenade.
Head over there.
We're just gonna use a grenade. I don't care. That's fine. I have them for situations like these, which is to kill the stupid, loud, annoying dudes. Molotov cocktail is great. I want to watch it burn. Burn. Are you dead yet? One more. God, thank you. Ugh. All right, let's take Jezebel and let's get this guy charging at us. This is gonna be a little bit of a long episode because of it. That's just fine. There he goes. Fragmentation. Is anybody else dangerous coming after us? Okay. Pulse. No, he can't come up here. Holy shnikes, he can move quick. Whoo. Oh, he's got a skull on him. Okay, dudes. Well, now that we've seen this guy in action, I'm gonna... Oh, God, it's back! Okay, now that we've seen this guy in action, I'm gonna stop the episode here. Next episode, first thing we're doing is we're fighting that guy. So, dudes, thank you so much for watching. It was a total joy to have you here. If you liked what you saw, please leave a like. Hit the subscribe button underneath me. Remember to vote and let me know what kind of you're cool with the big sweeping in kind of intros. And, of course, thank you so much for being here. Total joy. Ground rise to meet your feet. Wind should always be at your back. And may the sunshine warmly on your sexy, sexy face. Dudes, see you later. Bye.